program created by the Rio Grande Oil Company.
Los Angeles Police calling all cars. Attention all cars. Broadcast 161. Be on the lookout for the following described man wanted in connection with a killing at 817 East 3rd Street. Described as about 60 years, wears mustache and Van Dyke, has black hair, squint eyes, weight 160 pounds, dark complexion, was last seen near 817 East 3rd Street. This man is armed and dangerous. That's all. Rolls and quits.
Approximately $100 worth of gasoline a year, you are naturally interested in getting the most for your gasoline money. We try to respect this attitude. Though we make no claims for Rio Grande gasoline, which cannot be fully supported. When we tell you Rio Grande cracked gasoline starts quicker and develops more power per gallon, we explain that this is because of the patented Sinclair cracking process used exclusively in this territory by the Rio Grande Oil Company. This famous process strips gasoline of slow-burning fractions. It cracks or breaks up the remainder into tiny atoms that burn more readily and more completely, thus giving you greater power and greater mileage. Then we point to the one group of motor vehicles which give gasoline its supreme test: the police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and other emergency equipment of our cities and counties. More of these cars use Rio Grande cracked gasoline wherever it is sold than any other brand. We challenge you to submit a stronger testimonial than that. And we challenge you to name a gasoline for which claims as reasonable and logical and convincing are made. Try Rio Grande cracked, the gasoline of police car performance. See for yourself whether or not you get the same flashing responsiveness police cars get. Make a test tomorrow. See your nearest Rio Grande dealer. Once again, it is our pleasure to present Chief James E. Davis of the Los Angeles Police Department. Chief Davis.
Good evening, friends. Tonight, you will hear a story that illustrates in many ways the danger of allowing radical indigents to roam loose about the city. You will hear how one of your finest police officers lost his life because he was lenient and tried to give a suspect a break. The story of Isaac Wolfgang, alias Fred Edwards, is just one of the many cases we have of this same type, the only difference lying in the fact that he went a step too far and killed a man. In doing this, he made a mistake that brought the entire police force into sudden action and cost him man's most valuable possession, his life.
Early morning in downtown Los Angeles, November 4th, 1922. Merchants Fire Dispatch Officer H.A. Rude's attention is suddenly attracted by a cry of "Stop thief!" The sound of hard shoes pounding on the concrete sidewalk ahead of him. Looking up, he sees a man disappearing around the next corner at a dead run. Another man in pursuit. Joining the chase, he overhauls the second man, recognizes him as the watchman from a nearby building, leaves him behind. For three blocks, the mad race continues. Then, at the corner of 3rd and Alameda Streets, Officer Oliver Dinsmore spots the fugitive, joins the strange pursuit. Two blocks later, the two officers apprehend the breathless suspect and bring him to a halt.
All right. Take it easy. Take it easy.
I'll give it back.
You're right there. You give it back. And that's not all.
It's only one bottle of milk. That's all I got.
I don't care whether it's one bottle of milk or the Bank of Italy. You stole it, didn't you?
Yeah. I only wanted to borrow it.
Sure, I know how it is. How far did you chase this guy before I saw you, Harry?
About 3 blocks, I think. Far enough, anyway.
You see him take this milk?
No. No, that old watchman down by the warehouse caught it. I heard him yelling, and I joined in the fun.
I see. Well, come on, let's take a walk down to the station. I think the desk sergeant can handle this.
You're going to arrest me for despoying one bottle of milk? I told you I'd give it back.
Sure, they all want to give it back after it's too late. Come on, get moving.
So the milk-stealing individual, accompanied by Officer Dinsmore and Fire Officer Rood, starts a more leisurely trek, this time in the direction of the police station. For two blocks, the three walk in silence. Then...
Hey, I got something I want to ask you.
Go ahead.
You won't get sore?
I don't know. Suppose you ask me and find out.
Well, I live up here in this block. I got a room in a hotel.
So?
I want to know. Can I stop for a minute and get something?
You won't need anything where you're going. The city supplies everything.
But I want some money.
Money?
Yeah.
You've got money. What's the idea of stealing that milk?
I don't know. I just did it. That's all. I didn't mean anything wrong.
Well, I don't think your idea is so good. Leave your money where it is, and you'll have it when you come out.
But you see, if I go to jail, I won't get the job I was going to get. I saw tomorrow. It means a lot to me to get that job.
I don't know. It doesn't sound right to me. I think you're trying to give me a stall.
No, honest. I got to have that job. And if you let me get my money, I can bail out. Come on, give a guy a chance, will you?
What do you think, Harry?
Sounds like he might mean it.
I do mean it. Come on, ain't much to do for a guy.
All right, I'll take a gamble. But I'm telling you right here now, if you try any funny business when we get up there, it's going to be tough on you. Because I won't play.
There won't be any funny business. All I want is to get that dough.
All right. Show me the hotel and we'll go up.
So, believing the story, Officer Dinsmore follows his prisoner into a small rooming house. Up a flight of narrow, unlit stairs to a room marked 8. Then, while he and Rude stand at the door, their man walks to a dresser across the room, opens a drawer, fumbles a moment with something inside. Suddenly, he whirls, faces the two men, a snub-nosed Mauser automatic clutched in his right hand, as Dinsmore and Rude start falling.
Get out of here, or I'll let you have it too.
Are you dirty?
Get
a doctor and go up to room 8 fast. I'm going after that guy.
What's it all about? What's going
on
anyway?
Get a doctor and stop asking questions. There's a man up in 8 with a bullet through it.
But when Rude reaches the street, there is no sign of a vicious gunman. And after a quick search, he returns to room 8. Tries to stem the flow of blood from Officer Dinsmore's wound until the doctor arrives.
Take it easy, Oliver. It's going to be all right. The doctor will be here in a minute.
Thanks, Harry. It burns, boy.
Hey, I called the police. I guess that's about all I can do. But I seen him. I seen him running down the stairs.
You know who he is?
Yes, his name's Edward. That's about all I know about him.
Did you tell the police that?
Oh, well, they didn't ask me. Anyway, I was too excited. I couldn't even think right.
Yeah, that's fine. Now, listen. You'd better go down and stand by for the police. When they get here, bring them up on the run.
Yeah, yeah,
I'll stay here with Dinsmore.
All right, I'll do that.
Harry.
Yeah?
Can you imagine a guy doing that over a bottle of milk?
Don't talk, Oliver. Just take it easy until the doc gets here.
The doc can't do any good. I know.
You're crazy, fella. Everything's going to be slick. All you got to do is relax.
Yeah. Relax. The slug burning a hole inside of you. Just relax.
And Officer Dinsmore's words proved true. When a few seconds after the police ambulance arrived, he died. Immediately, Detective H.H. Klein, head of the Los Angeles Homicide Investigation Squad, throws every available man on the force into special duty, then questions the witnesses to the shooting.
You saw the actual shooting?
Yes, sir. I was at Dinsmore when we made the arrest.
And you could identify the man if you saw him again?
Absolutely, again.
Now, where's that other fellow, the one who called in?
Oh, that's me, Captain. I seen the fellow running down the stairs, and I tried to stop him, but somehow he just got by me.
Mm-hmm. How'd you try to stop him?
Well, I yelled at him, and I was going to grab at him, and...
But you changed your mind, huh? Right?
Well, You see, he was waving a gun, and he looks kind of crazy.
Oh, sure, I see. Never mind about the details of what you thought. Did you get a good look at him?
Oh, yes, sure. He was right in front of me. You know, it's a wonder he didn't shoot me, too. I tell you, it was a mighty bad situation for a fella to be
in.
You
recognize him as anyone you knew?
Oh, he lived here. I told this other fella here that his name was Edwards.
Well, that's right. Do you know anything more about him? What he does, if he works, anything that might help us to find him?
Well, no, sir. I'm sorry. I guess that's about all I know. Oh, say, maybe Mr. Devrin could help you.
Who's he?
Well, he's the fella that rents these rooms here, the proprietor, you might say.
What does he know about it?
Well, I don't know if he knows anything about this, but, well, he might know more about that Edwards.
All right. Suppose you go and find him, huh? And tell him I want to talk to him. I'll be in the room.
I'll do that, right?
Come on, boys. Let's look that room over. Might get a lead.
Accordingly, Detective Klein and his men proceed to the death room, begin a minute search of the killer's belongings. And in an old, battered trunk in the closet, they find a surprise.
Hey, will you get a load of this?
What's that?
This bird must have been planning a revolution or something. Look in here.
Looks like dynamite,
isn't it? It is dynamite. There's caps and fuses here to go with it.
All right, Jim. Come on, gather it up and we'll take it in with us.
All right.
Well, I've got through everything but this desk here.
Well. More and more, huh? You find some more?
Not dynamite, but jewelry. Hey, this guy's no amateur, whoever he is.
Hey. Pardon me, but if you want to talk to Mr. Devlin, he's here now.
Oh, it's you again. All right, come on in.
Yes, sir. This here is Mr. Devlin, the one I was telling about.
Yes, I remember. How long have you had this man living here, Mr. Devlin?
Well, quite some time. A month or even more, maybe.
What do you know about him?
He didn't associate much with me. I think he was working at some tree planting place.
You remember the name of it?
Well, I think it was the Wheeler Tree Planting Company. Only, I'm not sure whether it was tree planting or wrecking. One or the other.
Of course, there's not much difference.
What's that, sir?
Never mind. It was merely a remark. Oh, say, Jim.
Yes, sir?
Get on the phone and see if you can locate a Wheeler Tree Planting Company in the city. And if you don't find that, try and wrecking company. Let me know as soon as you can.
Yes, sir. I'll get right on.
Now, if you could give me a description of this Edwards. I have a general one already, but maybe you could make it clearer. Did he have any scars, any outstanding things, such as a limp? Anything that would help us in recognizing him?
I don't think so, sir. I saw very little of him, like I told you.
All right, thank you. Well, this our best bet is to run down this Wheeler outfit. You're sure the name is Wheeler?
Yes, sir. Why?
Just wondered, that's all. Thought maybe you might be confused about the name as well as the business. You see what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir.
A search of the telephone book reveals a Wheeler Wrecking Company at an address on Monita Street. But upon inquiry there, Klein discovers that it's closed for the day. From the watchman, he learns the phone number of the owner's home, and with this in hand, loses no time calling.
Is this Mr. Wheeler?
Yes.
This is Klein of the Los Angeles Police.
Yes.
I understand you have a man by the name of Edwards working for you. That right?
Edwards? Yes, I have a Fred Edwards who does some work for me.
When did you last see him, Mr. Wheeler?
About 20 minutes ago, maybe less.
He was there 20 minutes ago?
Yes. Hey, what's all this about, anyway?
Well, I haven't time to explain now, Mr. Wheeler. Just stay where you are until I get out there, will you?
Yes, of course, if you say so. But...
What's the address out there?
2720 Hoover.
Good. I'll be out there in 5 minutes. And please, Mr. Wheeler, this is a matter of great importance. If Edwards comes back, stall him. Make some excuse, but don't tell him of this call. You understand?
Yes, sir, I guess I do.
Good. Now, don't let anything slip.
So, with the first real lead since the shooting, Klein calls Captain Robards at headquarters. Tells him to have men sent out to cover the Hoover district, then rushes to the address himself. He is met by a considerably confused and upset gentleman who says he is Mr. Wheeler.
Oh, that's all right. Now, just a minute, Mr. Wheeler. I realize that you must be anxious to know what all this is about. And I think it'd be better if we talked in the house.
Yes, of course. I'm sorry to have been so rude, but you see, everything is so strange. I mean, Edwards' actions, and then, of course, your phone call.
Mm-hmm, of course, I see. Well, suppose we go in, and I'll tell you all about it.
Certainly. Certainly. Come right in, Mr. Brown. In here.
Thank you.
Now, please tell me, what is it all about?
Mr. Wheeler, we believe that the man who calls himself Edwards just shot and killed a police officer.
Good heavens.
He was arrested for stealing a quarter. And when the officer showed him a little consideration by going to his room with him, this man turned and shot him. He died a few minutes later.
Fred Edwards, killer. And why, I was talking to him right here in this room less than an hour ago.
Well, that's the reason why anything you can tell me now is of such importance. What did he say when you talked to him?
Well, he came in and he was very excited. He said he'd been in a little fight.
Was he bunged up?
Yes, he was. He had several small cuts and bruises on his face.
Go ahead, Mr. Wheeler.
Well, he said he'd been in a fight and that he needed some money for a doctor.
Did you give him any?
Yes, I owed him $15 in wages and I gave him that.
Cash or check?
Cash.
Well, that's too bad. Well, what'd he do then?
And he said he was going to a doctor's and that he'd be back tomorrow. Well, I guess he won't be back now.
No, not voluntarily. And, Mr. Wheeler, will you tell me what he was wearing and give me as complete a description as you can?
Of course. Now, let me see. As I remember, he had on a blue shirt, and it was open at the neck, and he had a dark suit. I think the coat sleeve was torn. Yes, it was, the right one.
Well, that's good for identification.
Yeah, now let me see. He was a dark-complexioned man, and he wore a mustache and a Van Dyke, and his eyes were sort of squinty, and he looked up from under.
Police calling all cars, attention all cars, all points bulletin, number 66473, wanted for murder, one Fred Edwards, weight 160 pounds, a foreigner, swarthy complexion, walks with a stoop, has black hair, black mustache, Van Dyke beard, wearing a dark suit, blue shirt, high top black shoes, medium build. This man is armed and desperate. All points take notice. Los Angeles Police, Captain Robert.
And in the office of the Radical Squad, Detectives Evans and Lane scan this new bulletin. Hasten to Captain Robert's office.
You want him to see me, man?
Yes, sir. I think I know this fellow described in this bulletin.
Edwards?
Yes, sir. This description fits a man we've been watching in connection with some bombings around town here. The only difference is the name.
What name have you got?
A Wolfgang, Isaac Wolfgang. We've had him under surveillance for some time. Lane here and I think he was connected with that Southern Pacific crack dynamiting.
That fits all right. Klein and the boys found several sticks of dynamite and everything to go with it in his room.
That's the fellow, all right.
I'll tell you what you do. Get out and see if you can get a trace on him. Lay aside anything else you're working on now and get on it. I'll get another bulletin out with this Wolfgang alias right away.
Right. Come on, Lane. Let's go.
Efficient wheels of the law's machinery turn faster. Draw the net tighter and tighter about fugitive Fred Edwards, alias Isaac Wolfgang. Every patrolman in the city stands satisfied. On the alert for a man answering the description provided on bulletin 66473, wanted for murder. Wanted for murder. Fred Edwards, alias Isaac Wolfgang. Description is in every hotel and rooming house in Los Angeles, plainclothes men look through registers.
You know a man answering this description?
Let me look. No, I think not.
Let's have a look at your register.
Sure, help yourself.
Let me see, Edison, Effie.
There ain't no Edwards there, no Wolfgang either.
I know, only I'm looking at every name in this book just the same. I'll see, Ellington, Henry.
At bus station, train terminal.
Wait a minute, buddy.
What's the matter?
What's your name?
What's it to you?
Now, listen, I don't want to play any games. What's your name?
Oh, you're a cop, huh? Well, my name is Smith, believe it or not.
You got identification on you?
Sure. I've worked in this bus station for 15 years.
Okay, we'll go over and see if they know you. If they do, it's okay with me. Come on, let's move.
Hour after hour at every place in the city where the fugitive might be, detectives In the plaza, meeting place for vagrants and transients, detectives Evans and Lane mingle with the crowd, hope against hope for a glimpse of him.
If we don't do something about it, no one will.
You think they get tired of it sometime and give up?
Yeah, I don't know how they do it. Not a dime between them, and yet they'd rather make speeches than look for work.
Matter of fact, if you offered any one of these tramps a job, they'd run the other way. They don't want to work.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, wait a minute.
You see him?
I don't know. I just saw a black mustache and a beard over there.
Hey, come on, let's see.
Yeah.
Who dares say this is a democracy?
Hey, there he is.
Wait till he turns around and get a better look at
it. It's him, all right. Come on.
No, wait a minute. No.
I say now.
You're right, it isn't.
And I'll say
before he turned around, I could have sworn it was.
Yeah, me too. Oh, well, come on. Let's browse along.
You know, it's a funny thing how a Chinaman can look so much like Wolfgang from the back, isn't it?
Destined for disappointment, as clue after clue runs out. In a steady procession, suspects are brought into headquarters only to be turned loose after they have proved their identity. Fred Edwards, alias Isaac Wolfgang, killer, dynamiter, seems to have completely disappeared. And as the day grows older, the search widens. Teletype communications from and to all nearby cities keep weary operators straining at their posts as a steady line of messages flash across the wires.
San Francisco Police, regarding your bulletin 66473, all points notified, rounding up all suspicious characters. We'll check back at regular intervals.
San Diego Police, a three men might be your wanted number 66473. Holding to your identification, please communicate at once with homicide.
Los Angeles Police, regarding our bulletin 66473, added information. This man might be hiding near in railway yard. Thought to have escaped on freight train from this city. If located, hold and notify immediately.
And in response to this last bulletin, officers Brody and Deason of the Los Angeles Police begin a careful search of the train yard. Watch each freight car for any suspicious movement.
Sort of like looking for a needle in the well-known haystack, huh, Brody?
Yeah. Not as much chance of finding a man in this mess as of me being made a captain tomorrow.
Some crack.
Now, come on. Let's take a look at this baby coming by. You look under the rods, and I'll look at the coupler.
Okay.
Hot coffee at this point.
Yeah, what are we waiting for? Come on, we can get it over at the open all-night joint by the barn.
I'd sure like to get my hands on this guy we're looking for. From what I heard, he never gave Dinsmore a chance.
That's what comes of trying to be decent with a bum. It sure burns me up when I think of him.
You and me both. Makes me so sore, I kind of think I'd like to find him and then have him start running.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean. Well, it can't do any good yelling about what we'd like to do. Let's get to that gather.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
Start walking again and don't look around.
All right. What's up?
Walk around the corner of this barn with me and I'll tell you. Come on. Yeah, that's all right, I guess.
Now, will you tell me what this is all about?
I think I saw a pair of man's legs standing on the other side of the freight car with a bat. I didn't want to stop until we were out of sight.
You think it might be?
I don't know. No, I'm going to walk back that way, and I'm going to have my gun in my hand under my coat. We'll walk around the other way and see if we can get behind them. Maybe that way we can take them without having any shooting scrapes.
Okay, let's go.
There he goes, Deason. Got it!
I see him. All right, hang on. Hang on by my leg, will you?
Don't worry, I got him all right. All right, you. Get on your feet and stick out your hands.
Yeah, dear. Why are you finished jumping at me like this?
What's your name?
What difference does it make to you?
My name's Fred Edwards, alias Isaac Wolfgang. Right?
No, it's not right.
No? And you're his twins? Now, come on and don't start anything if you don't want to get hurt. We don't like tramps like you, and it wouldn't break our hearts a bit to have to take you in flat. You understand?
Yes.
to remember it. Come on, Brody, let's go.
Taking no chances of an escape, the officers manacle their prisoner to each of their wrists. Then, secure in the knowledge that where he goes, they go too, they proceed to the police station. There, Detective Klein is notified of the arrest, and after a brief series of questions, escorts the prisoner to the little rooming house on East 3rd Street, calls for the proprietor, Mr. Devron, and asks one question.
Mr. Devron, is this the man you know as Fred Edwards?
Yes, sir. That's the one, all right.
He lived here in room 8?
Yes, sir.
That's all I wanted to know. Come on, Wolfgang. You're going back to the station with me, and you're going to answer a lot of questions. And when you're through doing that, you're going to jail until such a time as they get ready to hang you. Because if I have anything to do with it, that's just what they're going to do. Hang you.
Was right. He did have a great deal to do with it, and after a trial filled with many delays, Fred Edwards, alias Isaac Wolfgang, took the last long walk down death row to pay the supreme penalty, a life for a life.
Thank you, Chief Davis. As you listen to these exploits of the police in tracking down criminals, keep in mind that next to the fearlessness and ingenuity of the officers themselves, probably the greatest factor in their inevitable success is motor car performance. It is of paramount importance to you as a motorist to realize that more police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and other emergency equipment use Rio Grande cracked gasoline wherever it is sold than any other brand. That the police of so many of the West's greatest cities and counties, Los Angeles, Oakland, Berkeley, Fresno, Santa Barbara, San Diego, Maricopa County, Arizona, and many, many other cities and counties, have specified this police car performance gasoline month after month. You will find Sinclair Motor Oil superior, too. Sinclair operates the world's largest refinery, where the highest-priced Pennsylvania crude is de-waxed, de-jellied, and purified to become Sinclair Pennsylvania Motor Oil. Yet it costs you no more than motor oils that come from inferior Pennsylvania crude. Both Sinclair Pennsylvania and Sinclair Opaline come to you in refinery-sealed, tamper-proof cans. Ask your nearest independent Rio Grande dealer for a free copy of Calling All Cars News, which fully explains our complete new radio schedule. Also, fascinating stories of screen stars, radio stars, police stories, and special features. And now, in the spirit of this joyful climax to a good year just closing, the Rio Grande Oil Company extends the season's greetings and wishes you all happiness and prosperity in the better year just ahead.
Calling all cars, attention all cars, a cancellation broadcast 161 regarding a murder. Suspect in this case and now in custody. That's all. Rolls and face.